Hello, Tuolumne County people and round about the area. My name is Suzanne, and I'm a mother of six kids and the author of this crazy book right here. Yep, that was me back in the day when I was running the streets, running wild, running crazy, getting in trouble, getting arrested, dealing drugs, in and out of relationships, hanging out with gangs. My crazy wild story of coming through lots of ugly stuff and sexual abuse and sexual assault. And just my journey of finding out that the only way to have a father is to make God your father. I had this feeling of being really lonely, this deep feeling of like depression and longing for a place to belong. And I would go from relationship to relationship, from breakup to breakup, from guy to guy, just trying to find somewhere to belong. And I never found the place to belong in human form. I found it in God. I know it sounds corny to some of you, but it's the truth. I tried everything else that you can try. I tried every religion. I tried every kind of belief system. I tried gangs. I tried drugs. I tried men. I tried all kinds of weird Eastern religions. I tried Satanism. I tried it all, my friends. And there's only one place that I found that I belonged, and that's in the arms of Christ, my Savior. And it's real and it works. And I'm gonna share with you a verse. Greater love has no man than this, than to lay down one's life for his friends. That's John 15:13. After Jesus died on the cross, there was a man named Paul that came and preached the gospel to the whole world during that time. He was accused of turning the whole world upside down because he preached Jesus Christ, who died for human beings who didn't love him, who didn't want anything to do with him. He still died for those people, and he rose again, and he is living today. And Paul went around the world preaching this, and Paul wrote this verse in Romans, which is a book of the Bible, chapter 5, verse 7. For very rarely will anyone die for a righteous man, though for a good man, someone might possibly dare to die. People don't give up their lives usually for an unrighteous or an innocent man, but it's possible. Paul says that perhaps for a good man, someone might die. Like if it's really your brother and you're really loyal, you might, and they need you to do something for them, you might give up your freedom or die for that person, but it's rare. So back during Paul's time in Greek mythology, there was this famous story of Alcestis being the girlfriend and Admetus being the boyfriend. Admetus is good looking, he's a pillar of the community, he's handsome, and he has got it all together. He's got the money, he's got the fame, the community loves him, and he's good looking, all right? Alcestis is equally beautiful, she's gorgeous, and she's a lovely person. They're a power couple, all right? These two together, Alcestis and Admetus, they are a good looking couple. Well, Admetus gets wrongly accused of a crime and he gets sentenced by the judge to death and he's innocent. And so Alcestis says, I will give my life. She goes and she talks to the judge and she says, I know you can't change your law for Admetus. I know that he must die because that's what the law says. And back then the law couldn't change. The law was the law. There was no appeal. Admetus was doomed to die. But Alcestis says to the judge, she cries and pours out her heart and she says, I love Admetus. I will die for him in his place. And the judge says, okay, you can die for Admetus. And the judge allows Alcestis, the girlfriend, to die for her boyfriend, Admetus. And back in the Greek times, this was their idea of the highest form of love and loyalty. It didn't get any higher than this. And Paul is saying, oh, no, 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 au contraire, mon frère, There's a higher form of love. Because, see, Admetus was good looking. He was a nice guy, and the community loved him. Paul is saying, oh, no, God's love is greater than your Greek mythology story. God's love is greater because when we human beings, when we're not good looking, when we're mean, when we're ugly in our character, when we do bad things, when we don't deserve any mercy or kindness, God says, I love you then. I love you when you're weak. I love you when you're my enemy. I love you when you're a sinner. I love you when you're actively doing things against me to hurt me. I still love you. And this kind of love, Paul calls a very special kind of love, and there was no word for it back then. But this kind of love was called and is called today agape love. It is the selfless, changeless, unconditional love of God. See, human love, it's conditional. You like your girlfriend because she looks a certain way and she acts a certain way. And you love your boyfriend because he treats you a certain way. And there are certain things that attract you to that person. But God's agape love loves us unconditionally. And when there's nothing attractive about us, God is attracted to us. And he chases us down. And he follows us. And he stalks us in the night when we're running from him. And we don't want to be sober. He's chasing after us. And he's like, no, I love you. And I have tried every religion, and in every single religion, human beings have to go and search for the divine. We have to go and search for God. We have to go and search for the experience. Muhammad must go to the mountain. But you know what? In Christianity is the only religion where God comes in search of us. He's out looking for us. This is agape love. This is no greater love than this, than Christ laid down his life for you. Even when you're not innocent, even when you have a bad attitude, even when you're using again, even when you make a mistake and you're like, oh man, why did I do that? Even when you mess up, God's love, that agape love, is chasing you down and following you, and it's not gonna leave you. Human love is conditional. I don't have a mom. I miss my mom. I love my mom. But she has disowned me for standing up for things I had to stand up for. And that hurts. But because that's human love, it's conditional. It can reject. But God's love never rejects us, never leaves us. So the principle of agape love is that God's love is selfless, changeless, and unconditional. It doesn't matter what you do, what you say, where you go, who you are, what you look like, how much money you have. It doesn't matter. None of that stuff matters because God's agape love loves you just as you are right now. There's this story, this famous story in the Philippines of these two brothers. They're twin brothers. They look identical. They look exactly like each other. And one of them has a family life, and he's got wife, and he's got kids. And the other twin, he's a taxi driver and just kind of lives his life and punches the clock and does his thing. Well, the family man with the wife and the kids, he gets accused of a crime. And he gets sentenced to life in prison in Manila. And this prison that he's sentenced to is not your normal everyday prison. This is one of the worst prisons that you could ever get sent to. There's cockroaches everywhere. There's people dying and getting knifed to death. It is a violent, scary place that I hope none of us ever see. The brother's stuck there. He's without his wife, he's without his children. And his brother, the taxi driver, comes to visit him one day, and he says, when the guards aren't looking, I want you to trade clothes with me. And you're gonna wear my clothes out of here, home to your family. and I'm gonna take your prison clothes, and I'm gonna take your place there in prison. And the brother's like, why would you do that? You don't wanna be in this place. You don't wanna be here. But the taxi cab driver, the twin, he says that we're doing this. So they wait till the guards aren't looking, and this is a true story. They wait till the guards aren't looking, and they swap clothes. The taxi driver brother puts on the prison clothes, and the other brother puts on the street clothes, and he walks out of the prison and goes home to his family. And you've got to know that, like, every time that family man is home with his family, that he's thinking about his brother back in this horrible prison. And this is a good example, albeit a human example, of greater love hath no man than this, than he laid down his life for his friend. Christ has taken your place with guilt, shame, and sin. Christ has taken your place. He's put on those prison clothes, and he has taken your place so that you can have freedom. He's given his life for you. John 3:16 is the greatest verse of all time. For God so loved the world that he gave his only son, that whoever should believe in him will not die, but have everlasting life. And this verse is amazing because it means God, who is the greatest person of all, so loved with his agape love, the greatest devotion of love, the world, the greatest number of people, all people in the world, that he gave, he did the greatest act in all history. He gave his life, an innocent life for the guilty. His only begotten son, the greatest gift that whoever believes, the greatest condition should not perish, which is the greatest mercy, and have everlasting life, which is the greatest result. So now that you know that God has this unconditional, selfless, changeless love, unconditional. Did I say unconditional? I'm gonna say it again. Unconditional love. Now that you know that God has this kind of unconditional love for you, that he would take your place in whatever you're going through, he's with you, he's after you. What does he want from you? What does it take? You know what? All it takes is for you to believe in him and you can have eternal life. All it takes is for you to say, either out loud or in your heart right now, God, I believe in Jesus. I give you permission to work in my life. So once a person believes, Jesus becomes their surety. What does that mean, surety? Well, when you get arrested for a crime and you get put in jail, most people want to get bailed out as soon as possible. Christ in the Bible, Jesus Christ, is called the bail bondsman. He's the bondsman. He is our freedom. So anyone who goes to jail is wishing that they could get out of jail. And in some cases, people can pay money to get out of jail. They're bailed out. And the person that bailed them out is then responsible for that person to show up for trial. So if the person doesn't show up for his or her trial, then the bondsman, whoever bailed them out, is on the hook, and the bondsman can lose everything, and in some cases, even lose their freedom. When the first man, Adam, knowingly chose to follow Satan instead of God, God and Jesus made a plan to save the entire human race. That promise made Jesus Christ the bondsman. He made Jesus the bail. And Jesus was guaranteeing us humans with his life that God would keep his promise to save us from sin and death if we would accept Jesus Christ as our Savior. Jesus is the surety of that promise, which means that when we fail and mess up, Jesus says, I will take the punishment upon myself. He puts on that prison uniform and switches with you. He has taken your place. Jesus says, I will take the punishment upon myself. Guys, it's as easy as that. It is easy to be saved, and it is hard to be lost if you understand how good the good news of Jesus Christ is. If you understand how amazing and deep this agape love is, it is easy to be saved and hard to be lost because God is pursuing you. The only way to be lost is to knowingly and persistently reject this mercy and grace of God. God is not trying to keep you out of heaven. He is working hard. He's putting all powers of heaven into action to save you, to bring you into heaven, to bring you into relationship with Him. I want to encourage you today that you can have peace with God by simply saying, Lord Jesus, I believe in you. I give you permission to work in my life. You can experience that selfless, changeless, unconditional love of God just by saying that out loud or in your heart, or write it down when you get alone sometime. Spend 5 minutes with your Bible. Just open it up and see what God has to say to you. Because greater love hath no man than this, than Jesus Christ gave, laid down his life, traded places with you so that you could live. He died so that you could be free. He died so that, and rose again, so that we, this girl and you, can experience eternal life and a relationship with a God who is pursuing you, coming after you, and putting all powers of heaven to watch over you, to protect you, to bring you into a knowledge of who He is. Jesus Christ loves you, and all He wants from you, it's as simple and as easy as that, is to believe in Him and tell Him, Lord, get to work in my life because I need it. And that's all that you need to do today. And I ask you to do that because God has a selfless, changeless, unconditional love for you.